Welcome on all to Firewatch episode 2, I guess. I'm just gotta get through this part.
I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either. I don't really know why that would be the case. I mean, we've had issues with the radios going out in this area before.
There's no backup?
The backup is the 2-day hike out of here.
So, that's a no?
It's easier for me to send all the lookouts out to check the status of the wire in their areas. Yours is a good hike away. If you find any portion of it down, I can try to get a hold of a ranger and he'll bring someone in to fix it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
Remember that cave you hiked through yesterday?
Yeah, of course.
So, you're gonna want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
It's Henry.
What, you don't like Hank?
Yeah, I don't like Hank.
But thanks rhymes with Hank.
No, it doesn't.
Okay, alright.
You know what a good game would be played? Guess who? Over the... You know, putting that over the stove is not a good thing. Not 20, huh?
There's a map in my tower that I'm pretty sure is not USGS regulation, unless I've unknowingly been assigned to work in two orcs, and the lake to the east is made of acid.
That sounds erroneous.
Looks like the previous resident was into fantasy.
Can't get it. I just hope I did not get copyright striked in the last episode by the time this goes up. By the time I'm probably gonna find out hard anyways. Nice to live out there. What was that? Wow, that's where the wood was. That's not good. Let's see, where's that? I have to head north to it first. No, I'm going the wrong way. Yeah, there's the outhouse. Alright, I'm gonna have to put that back in the... How did that happen? Okay, let's put this inside the tower. I wonder what happened to the radio. Can't jump over things. But you can run at least. Nowadays, they have those generators, from what I've been told, at these ranger stations and places like that are like this far out, but they also have... They also have solar panels now, and battery banks. Where's the outhouse? So, where did I put the outhouse? Where'd I put it? Seriously, how do you lose an outhouse? Ah, there it is. Okay, baseball is put away. Hey, toss them. Obviously that guy, not the two hikers. Where was that?
You wake up pretty early then, huh?
As soon as the sun comes up. Forest Service really frowns on us putting up curtains for some reason.
I just covered my head with my pillow. Seems to do the trick.
Wow. The forest could never burn down on your watch.
Can you see the communication wires from where you are?
I can see the poles, but I have no idea if the wire is in good shape or not. They run a good distance up to a spot called Beartooth Point. You just need to walk along them all the way up there and make sure everything's in ship shape.
Through the cave. I'm still gonna get copyright for that song. I know it. I doubt I can reach it from there, though. Hold on, folks. Wrong number. Why is it always when I'm trying to do a stream or something, something like this happens? I swear, this game is way too demanding. To fix that. Oh wow, look at the mist.
It's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold in Boulder, though, right?
Yeah, they are.
What did you get up to down there? I mean, what's life like?
I don't know. I used to just spend a lot of time with our dog, Bucket.
Aw, that's a good name.
He was a good dog.
What type?
A beagle. We got him from the pound.
That's great. Hey, can you hold on a sec?
Sure. Just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you? Okay, good. No, I don't think he has any idea.
Hey, your button is still down.
I'm absolutely sure. Would you?
Delilah, I can hear you.
All right, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard.
I said I could...
Hey, sorry about that.
What, are you talking
anyway,
about me?
Bucket's a cute name. You owned him with someone?
Who was that?
Who was who?
I don't think he has any idea. What was that? Were you talking about me?
What?
You left your button pressed or something.
Henry, that call was work. I was just talking to... Actually, it's not really your business. Why are you freaking out?
I'm not freaking out.
Good. I'm gonna go quiet for a little bit. Call me if it's important.
Yeah, whatever. As much as I wanted to talk. Jogging. She's annoyed. Well, that's just my luck. I annoy everyone. But that was a valid concern. She left the thing on? Was she talking about me or was she talking about something else? This place isn't that big if you think about it. It's actually kind of small. I mean, it only looks big, the illusion of it is.
Hey, I found a structure that might have been an outhouse once, I think.
Whoa, you don't need my permission to go to the bathroom, but, you know, use abandoned shitters at your own peril.
I mean, I'm in the right area?
Yeah, the wire runs quite a ways north. Just follow it up to the point that I mentioned.
I found an old notepad of, I guess, songs. Someone was writing a song called Old Shoshone.
Old Shoshone, where the sky is blue and the teens are nude.
It's just like that, except about 10 times more depressing.
This way. Why do I get the feeling that this is going to be some sort of thriller?
trash box. How do you get up there? Updated.
Hey, who are these guys, Ron and Dave? They're leaving notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance one of them was that guy I saw in the canyon? You know, the guy with the flashlight?
No, they're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know them that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was chasing tail and getting loaded. It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a topless Polaroid.
Ah, yes, before the internet. Ah, yes, the days before internets. The pole.
Yeah, okay, the wire's down here.
Really? Awesome. Good find.
It's like, I don't know, a mile and a half east of me. You just follow the trail up the hill, you can't miss it. I'll go see what the damage is.
Invisible wall.
I found a turtle. Maybe it's a tortoise. It's a thing with a shell.
Well, isn't that something?
It's actually pretty cute.
Well, Henry, if you decide you want it to keep you company, nobody will mind.
Now, what do I call it? Looks like a,
Oh, this ought to be good.
Bucket Junior.
Perfect.
I think so.
Invisible walls. Six Feet Down Under, that'd be an interesting game. I mean, not name for a murder mystery or a game. Oh yeah, I can see how that would be a mistake, because you're looking through binoculars instead of...
Guess what?
What is it?
There's a bunch of empty cans up here.
Same as before?
Yep.
These fucking kids.
Why do you think they'd be up here?
Hell if I know, but they better have stayed away from our communication stuff.
Alright.
can see the wire you're talking about. It looks like it's in good shape from here.
We'll follow it up to the top of the trail if you can. You can head back as soon as you give me the all clear.
Got it. So we really can't reach anyone any other way than these wires?
What else do you suggest? Smoke signals?
Just seems dangerous.
Well, if they don't hear from me for a few days, they'll send someone out, but I'd rather it not come to that.
Can't pick up those other cans. Wonder if this is actually based on an actual location in Colorado.
So the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it. Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
I knew it. The moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Hmm. Let's hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I am gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Well, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something. I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
Oh, there's more cans. Well, this is a very narrative intense story. This poor book's getting abused so much by just being this way. I mean, this wasn't there on the way up, was it? Those cans? I don't remember seeing them. Why can't I put the book away? Going towards a supply drop, okay. All right, better get back to the tower and put this thing in the books.
I've got an overgrown trail here.
Yeah, that'll happen.
So I'm screwed when it comes to getting past it?
Mm-hmm. Screwed until you clear it yourself, yeah.
Great. Well, if I come across some tools, I'll add groundskeeping to my ever-increasing list of responsibilities.
Doesn't look like there are any more of those things there, but still. Oh, shortcut. I probably looped around. Okay. Oh, and the trail comes from there on the right. Somewhere over there.
Well, I hopped down a drop and now I can't climb back up.
Is a pickle.
I can just keep hiking, but I figured I should let you know in case I get myself trapped out here.
Well, hopefully that doesn't happen before you find these assholes. I was thinking you should probably head back to where you saw them last.
Yeah, there's the trail. Should have taken the book with me to the tower back, but oh well. I wonder if there's an achievement for this one. Seriously though, why can't I put it in my backpack? Go check the supply drop area. Why is it holding that book actually causes a lot of lag? Cache 241.
I'm out at a ravine. What's this thing that spans across it?
That is how you get to my sector.
No kidding. Well, let me hike over.
Well, it's locked up and mainly for emergencies. I've never actually used it. Rangers use it from time to time, but that's it.
Help! Oh, God, it's an emergency!
Oh, really?
Yeah, I got eyes on a tornado. I gotta get out of here.
A tornado in the heart of the Rockies?
Yes.
Holy moly, I need to call this in. Tom, Two Forks sees a tornado. He says he needs an evac into my sector. It's a meteorological impossibility. There haven't been tornadoes in the greater Yellowstone region in 100 million years. You're gonna need him to stay and take a detailed personal account, even if it means giving his life. Okay, I'll tell him. Sorry, Hank. No dice.
Man.
That was funny. Her sector, huh? That's the only way to and from. That was bad. Wow. This is, yeah, a bit of a walking simulator, but at least it has a little bit of interaction to it. I'll say this is a lot better than the Everyone Goes to the Rapture. By a lot. Did I just dump the book? Yeah, I did. How stupid of me. Well, if I'm lucky, it'll be there when I get back, but... let's see, where am I at? Where's my rope?
Climbing and jumping, it's pretty invigorating.
Just wait for the rest of the summer when you'll be sitting on your fat ass 14 hours a day.
I think I'm stuck.
Do you see anything from yours, like, you know, the clues as to where they could be?
Clues. I really like your enthusiasm for mystery.
I'm just doing my job.
I like it. I do. I can't wait for you to give these girls a piece of our minds, collective. But no clues. I can't see anything from here.
If that's in my sector, the telephone pole, how is she affected by it? Oh, okay.
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
Brian Goodwin's back. Ooh. Camera.
Well, I am flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them, in decent condition, too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Routine.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
What, was he a fella you had a thing with?
Yeah, it was so hot and heavy. Of course, Brian Goodwin was 12 years old, so, you know, our love could never really be understood. I'm kidding. Not about him being an actual 12-year-old. That part's true. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago. Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
Why? Where did they go?
I don't know. I never really hit it off with old Ned, and, one day they were just gone. Sucks. Anyway, so it
sounds suspicious.
Have fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photodome employee.
I don't know. I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
Seriously, why is holding that book cause that? Oh, there it is. Map information. Photodome. I think it's like that old codec stuff. Guess he's going out with Debbie next week. No, not that. Ooh. Steve. It's your man, Ron. Da da da.
Someone found a fossil and put it in a cash box.
Could be the same person who left that antler.
And maybe they're leaving me an entire creature, piece by piece. I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards Five Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood. Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Will do.
So let's see, that puts us at about
'Cause I can do?
No. I want this guy to have to roll his lazy ass all the way out here.
It flapjack is a choice phrase, by the way.
It really fits the bill in this case. Snapping at you earlier. I thought about it, and yeah, I suppose that must have sounded kind of weird when you heard me take that other call. Plus, you're just out here in your own head. Trust me, I know how it is. So, did you break any hearts back in Colorado when you took this job? I myself have chosen to never get attached to anyone who would miss me, but I know I'm a bit of an outlier. I don't mean that the way it sounds. I mean, I care about people, and I like companionship as much as the next person. But why does it have to come from the same person for your whole life? My Aunt Kathy was married to the same guy for 4 decades, and when he died, she found out he'd been having an affair with a real estate broker for 15 years. Whereas my Aunt Judy traveled the world dating artists and musicians as she saw fit. Call me crazy, but I'd rather spend a week in bed with Sonny Bono than half a lifetime with some cheating stockbroker.
My sister knows somebody who's related to Sonny Bono.
I'm actually married.
But you're here.
She's sick, and I shouldn't be here, but I am.
I'm sorry, Henry. What is it?
We'll get into it.
Okay. Well, in the meantime, you are here, and it's beautiful, and escaping isn't always something bad.
Yeah, sure.
Look, I gotta go do a thing, but I'll have a radio. Okay, call me if you need to.
I find honesty is usually a better policy. Plus, it gets sympathy. Let's see if there's a... Let's attach that rope hook. And then let's get the other one. Better to be prepared ahead of time. Although someone else could probably use it. It's just as important I be able to have a chance to use it. A climb rocks sort of thing. it's getting close to my end of the time limit, so I'd have to say thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. Please remember to rate, comment, and subscribe. If you enjoyed this, please donate to my Patreon or PayPal. And if you wish to follow me on Twitter, links will be in the description for everything. And I thank you and God bless every last one of you for showing up and watching my stuff. It really does help me, and I really appreciate every little bit. So, see you guys in the next episode.